going on, peeps? It's Wrath here, hanging out today, playing some Monster Legends. I want to thank you guys so much for coming out with me today. If you like the video, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button to show your support. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe as well. Alright guys, little thing I noticed here, I don't know why, it just caught me kind of funny here. They're talking about playing more social point games here. I guess this is, it looks like Dragon City perhaps, maybe a different Dragon game, but they're advertising their player versus player system. I don't know, if you play Monster Legends and you've seen how PvP works in this game, do you really want to play another game with their PvP system? Probably not. But anyways, I don't know, probably not their best selling point for their try my other game feature, but whatevs. Today, we're going to talk about races, and undoubtedly, there's going to be a little bit of negativity here. All right, it's going to happen. All right, every time races come around, my butthole gets a little bit angered. I don't know why it does, but it does. I just don't like it. I do not like the races, but whatever. We still got to cover them because they're a new event, and peeps play them. All right, peeps do it, so we got to cover it, and that's what we're going to do. So first up, before we jump in to check out the races and stuff like that, we're going to talk about a couple of natural little tips that will help you out a little bit. All right, there's a couple really obvious ones I'm not going to really go deep into, like when you had to collect food and collect gold and stuff like that. Those are obviously very simple nodes. The biggest thing to watch out for on those is the individual nodes. Okay, if there's a really big individual node for feeding monsters or collecting gold, make sure you communicate with your team and make sure you're not sniping somebody else that's already, you know, halfway or three quarters of the way there, because then you both end up collecting a million food or whatever, or spending a million food where really only one person had to. Now, if you have millions and millions of food in your team, not a huge big deal, but for a newer team that can be a real big roadblock for you, because if that node pops up again right next time and you just collected all your food or spent all your food, now you're gonna be in a little bit of trouble. So make sure you communicate with your team and know when you're going for the big individual nodes and stuff like that. Most of the other stuff's pretty self-explanatory. A lot of it is like the crafting runes. Duh, it's not really tough to craft runes. Everyone knows what you got to do there. You put the runes in the crafter and then you craft the runes. What you do? Do I get a level 5 here? Come on. Nope, level 4 again. Whatever. We'll take it. The ranking up of monsters. There's only 3 monsters pretty much that you'll ever rank up for the ranking nodes. Obviously, when the epic rank up comes around, that just comes off your own volition. There is one epic monster that ranks up faster than the rest, but that is Dragonian Beast here. It does have the fastest ranking time, I believe, in the game for epics. Could be wrong there, but I'm pretty sure I'm right. But either way, usually when the epic rank up comes around, it's just whatever epic you've got enough cells to rank up that you rank up. You might gem it finished, you might not, whatever. Okay, but when it comes to the rares, uncommons, and commons, there's 3 monsters always that you will use. That's going to be Pandakins. I don't know if I have a Greenosaur somewhere roaming about, so I do. Greenosaurs, look at him walking in front just in time. And then for your commons will be either Treezards or Firesaurs. The reason for that is you can breed Treezard and Firesaur very quickly, 15 seconds. You can also just buy their eggs, hatch them, and extract them, so you get a lot of their cells really easy, really fast. Same with the Greenosaur. You breed the Treezard and Firesaur together that you just hatched and bought, and you get the Greenosaurs every 30 seconds. You can also get a Pandakin every 30 seconds. So they're very easy to breed and extract and rank. So that's why you want to rank up those monsters at the easiest to do, and it'll be really fast for you. Now, a couple of things, some myths that I have heard in the area down here. The epic breeding nodes. Epic and legendary breeding nodes, they do come around. They do suck. Okay, there's no way around that. When your epic breeding node is over, individual epic breeding node is over 4 epics, generally what is the best practice to do is to breed 4 epics and then gem whatever's remaining. Because if you're not going to do that, you have to gem egg times, which is going to take you 20 plus gems every time you breed, gem up an egg speed hatch. Then you've got to get another epic breed and hope it's done and gem it, finish whatever. It's just a pain in the butt. So generally, once you get your 4 epic breeds, you gem whatever's remaining on the node and you call it a day. But anyways, there's a couple things here people say about breeding epics. A lot of people try the mersnake thing. They say, oh, just breed 2 mersnakes, you can get a Raz Fisher, a Fliplock, it's a pretty good chance. The biggest problem with that is the off-breed, okay? When you don't get the epic, you've got a 4-hour off-breed to get a mersnake, okay? So you've got to wait 4 hours before you can try again. Now, when you're breeding a Mushu here, you only have a 2.5-hour off-breed. Okay, so you breed Mersnake and Rockilla, the common Earth, and that gives you a chance to get Gastrosquish, which is a 2.5-hour off-breed, or Mushu. It's only 2 monsters you can get. But there is a 3rd option, and it's not a bad option. It's actually arguably better than the Mushu, and that is going to be... Where's the dude at? Do I have my Thundenix down here? I do. Thundenix, that's the dude in the middle. I'm the fire looking dude, and Tarzape, which I'm sure I've got one somewhere. So I just can't find him. He'll be somewhere, peeps. Is he up here? No, he's not. Whatever. He is the nature and earth, whatchacallit? The nature earth monkey looking dude. So that guy, bred with Thundenix, can give you four different epics. It can either give you the Griffex, the Rabidex, the Rhinex, or the Dragonian Beast, which is actually kind of nice. If you get those, you can extract them and rank them up very fast in the epic nodes, which is nice. But the big selling point for that breeding strategy is the biggest off time, if you don't get an epic breed, is going to be a Bonbon, which is only a 2-hour off breed. So it's actually a little bit faster in the off breed over the Mushu. So to put that in perspective here, if somebody else is doing Mersnakes, okay, and say they have two different habitats right here, both their breeders going with Mersnake, if they miss both their first breeds and they have a 4-hour off breed on both of their deals, if you run the Thundenix Tarzape deal, you're going to only have a 2-hour off breed if you miss yours, so you can, in effect, breed twice to get an epic before they can, for, you know, why they're breeding one time. So I think it's probably the better way to go, but whatevs, everybody's different. The most important thing to note on those big individual nodes is to make sure, one, you coordinate with your team so you're not trying to snipe somebody else's who's already bred like six epics and you're like, oh, I'll just gym the node, and you totally screw them over. Don't do that. That's not cool. But make sure you have somebody with a breeding guardian ready to go for that, because that's going to be very important, especially when it comes to breeding legendaries. Having two sets of monsters to breed a legendary comes in very handy there. For example, like this right here is a legendary breed. It's not a legendary breed, but it's a legendary breeding combo. Fae Melina and Dark Nubis. So if you're going to do the legendary node, having one combo that you can breed twice is very handy. So having two Fae Melinas and two Dark Nubis will give you twice as much of a chance to get a legendary. So that's definitely, obviously, better than just one chance. Right? My nose is itching. Gotta scratch it. Oh, scratch, scratch, scratch. Oh, it's amazing. All right, so... same thing with the epics. Having two Thundenix and two Tarzapes is definitely nice. It's going to allow you to breed twice for every time you try it. That's why I kind of like the Mushu. I've already got two Rockhills and two Mersnakes, so I can just kind of, you know, double up on the Mushu breeds. But there you go. That's pretty much everything you need to know about, like, the little tips and tricks. Right? The breeding nodes are always the hardest. There's nothing else really that difficult in the maze. PvP nodes, that is one thing that is still in the races. Make sure that, you're doing your PvP attacks. You can get some gems if you want to gym up and do a little faster attacks. Revenges do count. They do count for a point, so if you don't have any way to attack normally, you can go through your revenge pool and pull some wins out. But be careful, because, you know, going through 8 wins, you're probably going to clean up your revenge pile pretty quick. So it's nice to make sure you have a lot of people pitching in on the PvP nodes, because they do kind of suck. Right? I'm not going to lie. They suck. So with that being said, we're going to jump in and actually check out the race, and... I'm going to talk about why I hate this race, all right? I'm just going to say it. I do not like races. I never have. It's not my jam. Not my jam at all. I don't know what this race is called, actually. Apocalypse in the Mall. That's what it's called. There we go. Okay, so obviously... Oh, we got a new node. What do we got to do? 6 level 3 runes. That's no big thing. Well, whatever. We'll let some other people get these, and then we'll come back, because I'm doing a video right now. You know what I'm saying? Oop, just smack myself in my cord. Everybody calm down. Okay, so first up, the rewards. Everybody knows if you come in first, you get good rewards, right? That's the thing. And it's, I guess it's understandable. If you win, you should get the best rewards. But if you come in second down, so if you play second, say the first place has 500 laps and you have 499, second place, you're getting shafted. Big time and hugely hard. So that's how it works always. But in this race, it's even worse than normal, okay? For this reason. Every legendary that's not in the, like, Scrap Warrior seems like he'll be okay. He's nothing, like, super crazy, amazing OP. He's all right. Total Blind's kind of cool, but whatever. But if you come in second, you get Monster Device. All right? Not a very good monster, a really old monster. Not really that solid. Nobody really uses him because he's just not that good. Down here, Plymouth or Plymouth, whatever you want to call him. Same story. He's just not a very good monster. Kind of sucks. Down here, Rackhorn. I mean, I guess he has some decent damage, but he's not that good. So I understand that I guess they're supposed to be going through, like, Thanksgiving theme. I don't know why he got in there. But Plymouth is kind of Thanksgiving dude, and this guy's Thanksgiving. And then, obviously, if you get below that, you're going to get an epic, right? So that's the problem here, is that if you don't get first in this race, even more so than last race, would you scroll up there? There you go. You're really getting shafted, because the monster you're going to get really sucks. They're not going to be good. You're not gonna be, it's not like something I'm going to rank up. Like, ooh, I want a monster DVS to rank that guy up. You don't really want him. He's not that great of a monster. So in this race, the rewards are really actually worse than they've been since I've played the game. This is probably the worst race I've been in for reward-wise, which sucks. But, you know, it happens. Like I said, though, if they ever actually change the races where if you got, like, 14-plus laps or 20-plus laps, even if you didn't come in first, you still got a ranked monster, it would make these things much less annoying. But anyways, that's not all that annoys me. Let's go ahead and check out the teams here. As you may know, this is our bracket. You might not know these guys. This is the number two team in the freaking world. So we're pretty much butt-smashed in this one hardcore. We're not going to win this race at all. Not going to be a thing. It's only been a day in the race, so we've got 17 laps. Not going to happen. We haven't even qualified yet. We're really dragging balls, but I don't care. Like I said, I'm not really that worried about it. Races are not my favorite event. I don't like them. And especially this one. Like, the only reason I'd even ever recommend going for second or third in this thing is just for the Elementium. It's the only thing that's worth it in the second and below rankings is the Elementium you get. You know? It just kind of sucks, peeps. Not going to lie. I'm not big on it. The individual rewards did change a little bit as well. They now have people getting cells. It looks all the way down to, I guess, if you qualify, you get cells, which is cool. I'm okay with that. That's fine. But they did get rid of the Elementium here for, it looks like, relic chests or something. The relics, I'm not going to lie, I've not been really impressed with them. I don't think they're that great. But whatever. That's not a big deal. The Elementium wasn't a huge amount of Elementium anyway. So it's whatevs. So anyways, that is most about the race. I don't really like the race. It's my least favorite race of all races. I'm not a big fan of it for a couple of reasons. You know, not only does it just, like, the rewards kind of blow, it incentivizes people to leave teams and join teams and change, like, the entire dynamic of your team in a single day. That's what it does all the time, because people are looking for that team that's going to win. They don't really care if you come in second, because, like I said, there's no point in coming in second. If you're on a team that's going to win second, it's not really, there's no real big incentive to stay there. In races. And that's what's kind of stupid on Social Points End, is they've made their team-based game where you don't want to be in your team for all the events. And that's kind of stupid, in my opinion. That's why I don't really like the races. And in all honesty, I think the whole game in the last couple of months has really kind of taken a hit. Like, it's just not doing very well. It's feeling to me like it's not that fun anymore. It's not as fun as it was 3-4 months ago. You know, they changed PvP, it kind of sucked. They changed it back a little bit, still kind of sucks, but there's just not a lot going on. They're doing a ton and ton of races. It's like their favorite event now. They've done like 3 in the last month. They just keep dropping crap like this, and I think it's because they're trying to make a little bit money. You know, a little bit of money is kind of the motivation here, and that's what sucks with mobile gaming. All right, I'm just gonna say it. It's why I really want to get away from it, like, for my overall channel. I kind of want to get into console gaming. Probably gonna go start ordering some of that stuff tonight to get myself hooked up for it, but that's not the point. Like I said, that's what happens in mobile gaming, is they go for money. It's a very money-driven business, because you don't make any money on the download of the game. You only make money when people spend money in your game. So especially the longer a game goes, the more they start aiming towards the making money part, because they're just trying to get all the money they can out of their game before they either start up a new one or they move on to something entirely different. So that's kind of where this is. And not to mention, you know, the fact that PvP is still kind of in a crappy spot. There's just not a lot of stuff to do. The dungeons are pretty boring. There's not a lot of gameplay really even to do. So, like, for a normal player, it's not really a big deal if a bad event comes around, because it's like, you know, I just won't play the game that much this week. I'll play Xbox or something. But when you're a YouTuber, you've got to fight and scrap and find something to record on every day. It just kind of sucks. And that's why I want to get away from this, because it gets kind of stagnant, not going to lie. I want to get into doing some Ark or some Fortnite or something like that. Yeah, they're fun games. They're always going to be a challenge. There's always something different going on. I like that. So that's just kind of a little bit of a rant there at the end. Whatevs. Whatevs. But that's pretty much all you need to know about the race this week. All right. If you're not going to win, I would not recommend spending any gems on this event, due to the fact that the rewards really suck. Like, more than normally suck if you don't come in first, okay? Like, last race, we got Barbados for second and third. That wasn't a bad reward. I mean, obviously, been better if he was ranked up, because we got, like, you know, 20 laps, but whatever. This time, getting second and third, not even worth it, really. I wouldn't even, I would not recommend spending any gems. But there you go, peeps. That is this event. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions for future videos, don't forget to leave those in the down there, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you like the video, please make sure you smash that thumbs up button to show your support, and I will see you guys next time.